Hi, my name is Walt Bednarz with Design Point Solutions, and in this video I'm going to go through how you can relocate your EPDM archives. And the archives are actually the files that are stored within the Vault on the server. So you may come across a situation where you're running out of space for your Vault files on the server and you need to locate it on a different volume, or you want to split them up across different volumes. So it's pretty easy to do with the archive server configuration tool. Now I'm going to run through some precautions quickly here. You want to make sure nobody is in the vault. So you can do that by running a report. There are some reports available that can let you know if anybody's logged in and where they're logged in at. You can also just ask people, of course, or wait for a time that maybe people are not in the office at the end of the day when everybody's gone. And you may also want to lock users out using the admin utility after you know they're out so they don't come back in, maybe through remote access. And then another precaution, a good idea is to back things up or make sure that your last backup was good so that if anything did go wrong, you have a way to recover things. So procedure is pretty simple. What we'll do is we'll just run through this together. So you do want to make sure you have some folders available for this already. I have two folders set up here on my computer, one on my C drive and another on my E drive that I have on my computer. And they're physical drives, so I would split these across different locations. And I'm going to use the archive server configuration tool. So I'm just going to search on this from my window, and actually it's trying to open up another vault. I'm going to say I don't want to actually log into any vaults here. So we'll say again archive, bring up the archive server configuration. I'm going to take a quick look here and notice I'm not logged into any vaults. So if I expand this out here, I can see there's my vault. So you're going to find your vault in this dialog box in the archive server utility. Just expand that out and right mouse click on the vault and just go to relocate. And we'll see here what my current path is. So I'm currently located in just a default directory. The default directory is the program files, SOLIDWORKS Enterprise, PDM, data. And there's a folder within there that says my docs, and all my archive files would be in there. So I want to actually change this, and I'm just going to browse to a different path. And pretty simple, I've already created this path. Notice there's no new folder option here, so I'm going to go to the ones that I've already created. I have this EPDM Vault Archives folder here, and I'm going to make this, you can see it kind of snaps positions, 50% here. And then I'm going to add another location, and that's going to be on my E drive. And I'll choose that there. Notice it's not doing anything yet because total size is 50%, so I got the red light here. I'm going to make this 50%, gives me the green light. If I go over, I get the red light. So now I can split this across multiple volumes on my server, whereas if I might have had, I've been running out of space on my C drive, now I have a different attached volume that I can do this. Press OK. It's giving me a little warning here. Otherwise, press cancel, and it's going to start moving the archives, and you get this feedback here. So another thing to keep in mind is, yeah, you could put this on a network space and put it on remotely, but you're going to get some performance degradation by doing that. So just keep that in mind. You're going to want to keep these locally, and you want to think about, you know, these are your files that are being accessed by users off the vault. So you want something pretty speedy and local on the server. And that's it. That's relocating your EPDM archives.